ball up the court there quickly. And even the guy on the baseline alone.
Campbell looking for help. And a timeout called by Brad Stevens.
It's been everything is advertised being here. Two teams, there'll be a major factor come March Madness. And it all really, really counts. But right now, this has been one intense emotional battle. But right now, you're going to get the ball up the court and try it, obviously, and want to get a shot for Dunn. I think Dunn's the guy who wants to shoot the ball. He can shoot it. Where Jones has to penetrate and take too much time off the clock.
Now, you got 4.6 seconds. Clock doesn't start until the ball's touched in bounds. You got Smith as well. They got a few options.
Yeah, they got a few options, no question. But I think you want to release people to the glass like Smith and Jones, who are good offensive rebounders, and you want to get the ball in their hands before you shoot. And Dunn's the guy I'm like. But on the other side, they're going to count on that. They know about Dunn. So you got to really try to get him free with a good screen. Let's see what they do. They're not going to bump their guy to baseline. They want to throw it.
Campbell again. He's a guy who hardly ever plays, but obviously a guy they like to throw the long touchdown pass or football-type pass. He's going to be in there to inbound the ball again for Butler.
Don't remember this. When Hill and Laker, they allowed him to throw it.
A travel is called on Barlow.
He lifted his pivot foot. He lifted his pivot foot. There's the pass, and watch this. He dragged his pivot foot, no doubt about it. No doubt about it. Before he put the ball on the floor, the foot came up.
Now if they don't get an immediate steal, they'll have to
foul it away. And then you're gonna hope for a dramatic three.
Oh boy!
Oh, he got it, sir! Oh, yes!
Between him and Olynyk and Roosevelt Jones, who you described so accurately earlier as a winner with the winning shot. The officials are reviewing it to make sure it left his hand before the expiration of time. With the naked eye, it looked like it was good.
I thought it was good. Now they have to make a call, make a destined call, and then go. Yeah. And then they have to go and check the monitor.
Look at the far end. 0.1 on the clock. The ball's out of his hands. That looks like a good shot.
Good shot. But number one, they have to make the call. They have to make the call. This is someone with Butler.
Butler wins.
Undefeated at home. They're 9-0. Being a tough Rolls Royce team. Rolls team's going on. I'm going to play the hearts out. That's it. What a terrific fight, Dads. Fun being here with you.
Walking over near us. I think Shannon's going to get in for an interview. And all Brad said to us was, Hinkle magic. And there was some magic in the air here tonight as Roosevelt Jones saw the ball floating in the sky up above him, corralled it, and made that running one-hander with a tenth of a second left on the clock. And the Butler Bulldogs pull out an incredible win, 64-63.
I got to think about emotions. You got Barkfield, he's a cloud nine with a turnover by Barlow, and then here it is a moment later, Roosevelt Jones with a dramatic shot, gutty, tenacious.
More when we come back on SportsCenter. Brad Stevens and more reaction to the Butler win. Robert Flores and Jay Harris are standing by. 64-63, Butler beats Gonzaga. here at Hinkle.